Welcome back. This is Chicken Philosophy, Meccan Revelations Part 20, in which I will continue reading the Meccan Revelations. There's a "the," it's just very small. By Ibn al-Arabi, also known as Ibn Arabi, and he has a longer name, and I don't have it memorized, I admit. So, yes, we'll be picking up right where Edward left off last time. The one with the panning for psychedelic fool's gold. Continuing with the section on the helpers of the Mahdi. You know, I was thinking, this is part 20 of Meccan Revelations. And so I was thinking of what can I say about 20? And the first thing that came to mind was Kaf being the Wheel of Fortune. So the letter Kaf corresponds to the Wheel of Fortune, right? And Kaf is 20. But then I was thinking, oh, but Wheel of Fortune is not key 20. And if I'm not mistaken, and Editor Edward, I'm a bit rusty. I haven't been teaching Western esotericism for the past 11 years, at least not in a formal setting. A little bit of one-on-one coaching of very basic stuff that is like so deeply ingrained that I'll never forget it in my life. But some of the more nuanced concepts, might elude me these days because I don't regularly update. I don't, you know, humans, animals, they forget things over time. So Editor Edward, correct me if I'm wrong. And if I get through this whole thing and you don't see Editor Edward, that means I got it right. Key 20 is the path of judgment, right? Or the judgment card. And whereas the 20th path of the Sefer Yetzirah is the hermit. And so Kaf for Wheel of Fortune, Shin for judgment, and Yod for the hermit. This episode should be very cushy. Esoteric nerd jokes. They're not always funny. They don't always land, even among other esoteric nerds. There might have been a few groans out there, but everyone else is like, what the fuck? And the people who should click away have all already clicked away. Now it's just us. Isn't that nice? Now we can begin our reading. And if you would like to navigate the Meccan Revelations playlist and see all episodes from 1 to 20, when I'm lazy and I put the card in for the playlist, it shows up here as Meccan Revelations Part 1. But don't be fooled by YouTube. If you click that, it will take you to the whole playlist, not just Part 1, but Part 2, 3. And imagine that I said 4 and kept listing integers up to 19, as well as 20. 20 will be there too. By the time you're seeing this, this episode is also going to be in that playlist. I'm being a bit silly, aren't I? I'll just go ahead and get to the reading. I hope everybody's doing well. This is Monday, April something, 29th? I don't know. we're moving on to part five. So this was the characteristics of the spiritual station of the helpers of the Mahdi. And to make this more interesting, occasionally we visualize the Fremen from Dune. I suggest the original David Lynch Dune, but you can visualize the new Fremen if you want to. But that has much more of an edge to it of, yeah, but they're foolish. they're just silly because they're religious and they're being fooled by this cultural appropriating Atreides who's intentionally being a fake messiah, or a fake Mahdi. So I don't recommend, honestly, visualizing the new Fremen. I definitely recommend visualizing Ed from Twin Peaks as Stilgar. And of course, Agent Cooper as Paul, Muad'Dib, Usul, Atreides. Not necessarily in that order. Okay. Oh, and Special Agent Albert Rosenfeld's dad. I didn't even know this until recently. And I call myself a David Lynch fan. The actor, whose name I admit I don't know, but he was Bob in RoboCop, you know, with the two ladies, and he got blown up by the guy. You know who I'm talking about? The guy who was like the OCP executive behind the creation of RoboCop out of the corpse of Murphy. That guy, that actor, he passed away a few years ago. I was sad, a little. Anyway, that actor, who I really enjoy, played Special Agent Albert Rosenfeld. Let's just play a small clip here.
Buddhist tradition first came to the land of snow in the 5th century AD. The first Tibetan king to be touched by the Dharma was King Hathathol Rignan Butsan. He and succeeding kings were collectively known as the Happy Generations. Now, some historians place them in a water snake year, 213 AD. Others in the year of a water ox, 173 AD. Amazing, isn't it? The Happy Generations.
Agent Cooper, I am thrilled to pieces that the Dharma came to King Ho-Ho-Ho. I really am. But right now I'm trying hard to focus on the more immediate problems of our own century right here in Twin Peaks.
Yeah, he wasn't into any of Cooper's or Paul Atreides' nonsense about Tibetan Buddhism. He was much more in the here and now. He's like, hey, man, come back out of ancient Tibet and be here now. We're in Washington, not D.C. Never mind. Anyway, that actor, not Paul, but the other one, his dad, that actor's dad, played the Emperor of the Known Universe, Shaddam the Fourth?
Oh, yes.
Color me amazed.
In 10,181, yeah, anyway, so David Lynch ended up meeting. I'll just get to the reading, shall I? I hope everybody's doing well. 5. As for, quote, mercy in anger, end quote, that is only in the divinely prescribed penalties. And punishment, since in everything else, bracket parentheses, i.e. in merely human affairs, end bracket parentheses, it'll get good. Just hang in there. There is anger without any mercy at all. 4 dots. Or a period and then 3 dots. So the translators skipped a bit, and we don't get to know what they skipped. Thank you, Mr. Chodkiewicz. For if a human being gets angry of his own accord, his anger does not contain mercy in any respect. But if he becomes angry for God's sake, bracket parentheses, i.e. in fulfilling the divine commandments, and bracket parentheses, then his anger is God's anger, and God's anger is never free from being mixed with divine mercy. Maybe that's how it was in his day in the 1100s, but from what I've observed in my experience, at least from Protestant Christians, they tend to be less merciful when they think that their anger is divine. Whereas if they think that their anger is merely human, they will have mercy. In other words, if someone is like, ah, I don't like how this guy chews with his mouth open. It makes me so mad. But I'm not going to do anything about it because I should probably get over it. And it's probably just my conditioning and my bias, as, you know, he says his parents didn't teach him to chew with his mouth closed, and I should have mercy. I should respect that his background. You know, you feel the anger, but there's mercy mixed in. Merely human anger. But, if those satanic Hollywood, you know what I'm saying? If those people put a bill on the ballot saying that our children have to listen to this un-Christian nonsense, like the theory of evolution or something, then I will burn them to the fucking ground without mercy. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that they say that, and I'm cartooning it a little bit. Strawmanning, even. But, yeah, it's anyway, this is what he's saying contradicts what I've observed in 2024. Okay. Yes, becomes angry for God's sake, i.e. in fulfilling the divine commandments, then his anger is God's anger, and God's anger is never free from being mixed with divine mercy. Because, parentheses God's and parentheses mercy, since it preceded, bracket parentheses his and bracket parentheses anger, entirely covers all engendered being and extends to everything. Bracket parentheses Quran 7:156 and bracket parentheses three dots. So to you evangelicals out there, I would suggest reading a little more of the Quran so that you can be more like Christ, you know, merciful. Sorry, I'm just being an ass in case it wasn't obvious. I'm feeling assy today. Bit. Therefore, this Mahdi does not become angry except for God's sake, so that his anger does not go beyond bracket parentheses what is required in bracket parentheses upholding God's limits that he has prescribed. This is just the opposite of the bracket parentheses ordinary and bracket parentheses who becomes person who becomes angry because of his own desires for bracket parentheses something happening and bracket parentheses contrary to his own personal aims. Incel rage, for instance, would be that kind of anger, not divine in any way. And without mercy in many cases. So maybe I take back a little bit of what I said. It's a biased sample situation where if I look here, then, oh yeah, that's wrath without mercy, isn't it? And over here, well, that's wrath with some mercy, but only because of the separation of church and state. There's a little bit of like, well, okay, yeah, you can do that because... But never mind. I'll keep reading. Doodly-doo. And likewise, the person who becomes angry, bracket parentheses only and bracket parentheses for God's sake, can only be just and equitable, not tyrannical and unjust. Yeah. All that history that you're thinking of that contradicts that happened after this was written. Most of it, I think. Now a sign of whoever, bracket parentheses, rightfully, and bracket parentheses, lays claim to this spiritual station, is that if he becomes angry for God's sake while acting in judgment and upholding the bracket parentheses divinely prescribed and bracket parentheses penalty against the person with whom he is angry, then his anger disappears once he has finished fulfilling, bracket parentheses, that religious duty, and bracket parentheses. Have you seen 50 Shades of Grey? It's just like that, but divine. No. Not divine at all. No. What I mean to say is not like 50 Shades of Grey at all. But the anger does dissipate. Testosterone. It's a funny thing. Never mind. Is there music? I didn't tell Editor Edward to play music, but I'm certain that he must have played music, because really Editor Edward is me in the future, so. Okay. Yes. Sometimes he may even go up to the condemned person and embrace him and be friendly with him, saying to him, quote, praise be to God who has purified you, and openly showing his happiness and pleasure with him. Aspiring abusive husbands and fathers, I hope you're taking notes. This is how you do it. Okay. And openly showing his happiness and pleasure with him. And sometimes, the condemned man, also becomes friendly with, his judge, and, after that. I mean, he's either being intelligent or it's Stockholm Syndrome. I mean, not in this case. I'm sure that that's not what he means. He's talking about something else. And I'm just, again, being an ass. I'm sorry. If anybody's offended who hasn't already clicked away, maybe rage watching, I don't know, then be merciful as your God is merciful. You can click thumbs down, but then give me a hug and I'll love you, because it was divine anger, right? Sorry, never mind. After that, for this inner fulfillment and realization of the divine commandments and is God's scale of justice and oh, now I don't get to visualize like the scales of a lizard's skin. Now it has to be scales like scales. Darn it. The scales of justice. Oh, Lady Justice is a lizard person. Maybe. No. I have to say no, otherwise YouTube will block this video and say it's promoting dangerous conspiracy theories. Just kidding, I guess? I don't know. Gotta cover all my bases here. And all of, God's mercy, and, comes back to that condemned man. Well, I wonder how many parts there are of this about the Mahdi's helpers before he gets back into like the cool, trippy stuff about the nature of reality and the universe. I really enjoyed the beginning of this book. We're about this far through, and there's another volume after this. But surely there's got to be more than one section. This happens with the Buddhist books reading too, where it's like, okay, for the next 20 pages, we're going to be overtly sexist. And then as I'm reading it, I'm rolling my eyes and going, oh my God. I used to look up to Buddha, and now all I can do is... But then it finishes, and then it's like, okay, now let's talk about some cool, trippy, you know, meditation and the nature of things. And then I'm like back on board, you know, and I try to forget those 20 pages. Okay, now it's italics, which means Chodkiewicz and friends. Ibn Arabi proceeds to illustrate this phenomenon. Dun, 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 dun. Phenomenon. Dun, 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 dun. Phenomenon. Dun, 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 dun. Phenomenon. Dun, 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 dun. With the story, Roman numeral 3, 334, dot 2 through 8, and regular parentheses. Of a personal acquaintance who frequented the same masters of hadith in the city of Ceuta, a highly respected and unusually modest religious judge who was famous for his rare charismatic ability, or Baraka, good movie, to establish peace. So I guess that's charismatic ability is what they named their movie after. Peace, feuding parties or tribes. I think I skipped a word. Sometimes I skip the last word of a page. Peace among feuding parties or tribes. An ability Ibn Arabi attributes to his extreme conscientiousness and concern for maintaining only a disinterested, quote, divine point of view, end quote, in his inner relation to his legal duties. This leads him to take up the broader divine standards of judgment regarding all our actions, especially their inner spiritual aspect. Okay. So are we on 6 now or what? We're still on 5? Or we're not numbering anymore? 6 through 8. Oh, so we're still on 5 and then... Oh no, 6B. Where's 6A? I want to read up until we get to 6A. Okay. One more page. We can do this. Okay, now we're back. Or no, are we? What? What was I just reading? Yeah, so this is still, okay. Now we're going to read some more of part 5 of Ibn Arabi, translated into English, talking about this, the helpers of the Mahdi. This bracket parentheses necessary attention to the spiritual sources and repercussions of all our actions and bracket parentheses is also bracket parentheses expressed and bracket parentheses in God's saying, quote, three dots, and then we test your records, bracket parentheses of your actions and bracket parentheses, end quote, Quran 47:31. For first of all, he tests bracket parentheses mankind and bracket parentheses with regard to the obligations he has imposed on them, bracket parentheses, i.e. according to the first half of the same verse, quote, and surely we test you until we know those of you who make every effort and are patient, three dots, end quote, and bracket parentheses, semicolon, and if they have acted, bracket parentheses, in accordance with the divine commands, and bracket parentheses, then their actions are tested as to whether they have acted for the sake of the truth with a capital T. There are many who will say there is no such thing as truth with a capital T. Is that true with a capital T? I don't know. Or instead for some other end. Likewise, it is this bracket parentheses inner spiritual judgment that is expressed and bracket parentheses in God's saying, quote, on the day when the innermost selves are tested, end quote, Quran 86:9. For the people of inner unveiling hold this bracket parentheses, i.e. the judgment of each soul's innermost being, the sarira, and bracket parentheses to be God's scale, bracket parentheses of justice, and bracket parentheses. I paused so that you could picture God as a lizard king. He can do anything. The Doors, anybody? Sorry. Good call, Editor Edward. Therefore, the judge, whenever he is carrying out the bracket parentheses divine penalties, I'm doing a Jim Morrison impression if it wasn't obvious, which it wasn't because it's a terrible impression, must not forget to examine his own soul in order to guard against the feelings of vengeance and aggression that happen to souls, bracket parentheses, in such situations, and bracket parentheses, three dots. A little bit of Stan Laurel slipped into my Jim Morrison. Okay, we're back to italics, so this is Chodkwick and friends, the translator, not Ibn Arabi. Here, Ibn Arabi continues to explain how the above-mentioned Qadi in Ceuta was always careful to examine his conscience in this way. Edward, could you play just that one bit from Soft Parade, the opening where he's talking about, you cannot petition the Lord with prayer.
When I was back there in seminary school, there was a person there who put forth the proposition that you can petition the Lord with prayer. You cannot petition the Lord with prayer!
Jesus, Jim Morrison of the Doors. Say how you really feel. Okay. Where were we? Here, Ibn Arabi continues to explain how the above-mentioned Qadi in Ceuta was always careful to examine his conscience in this way, even when his emotions of anger or vengeance did not derive directly from the case actually before him. In fact, he concludes, the moral and spiritual factors involved in each case are so complex that the responsibility of judgment, in the ultimate all-inclusive sense of that term, can only belong to God, or those rare individuals divinely, quote, appointed, end quote, for this role. So you must know. Okay, now we're back to Ibn Arabi. This is Ibn Arabi from the 12th century? 13th century? I should know that. Talking to you. It's been translated into English, if it wasn't obvious, by the translators. So you must know that God has not appointed anyone but the judge to carry out the penalty against, bracket parentheses, the guilty person, end bracket parentheses. Therefore, no one, bracket parentheses, else, end bracket parentheses, should be angry with the person who transgresses God's limits. Since that, bracket parentheses, i.e. the responsibility of anger in imposing the divine penalties, and bracket parentheses, only belongs to the judges in particular, and to God's messenger insofar as he is a judge. For if, bracket parentheses, the messenger, and bracket parentheses, were only communicating, bracket parentheses, the divine message, and bracket parentheses, and not judging, then he would not carry out the, bracket parentheses, divine, and bracket parentheses, anger, with a capital A, against those who reject his call. Back to incel rage, right? Answer the phone, bitch! Right. That matter, bracket parentheses, i.e. their response, insofar as he is simply a messenger, and bracket parentheses, does not involve him at all, and he is not responsible for their being rightly guided, Quran 272. Thus God says to the messenger concerning this matter, quote, you are only responsible for communicating, bracket parentheses, the divine message, and bracket parentheses, end quote, Quran 42, 48, etc. So, bracket parentheses, the prophet, and bracket parentheses, communicated, and God caused whomever he wished to listen, Quran 8, 23, etc., and caused whomever he wished to be deaf, Quran 47, 23, and they, that is, the prophets, are the most self-restrained of men. For, bracket parentheses, even, and bracket parentheses, if the, bracket parentheses, prophetic, and bracket parentheses, caller, were, bracket parentheses, fully, and bracket parentheses, revealed to the person whom God has made deaf to his call, that person would still not hear the call, and would be changed, would not be changed because of that. And if the, bracket parentheses, prophet who is, and bracket parentheses, calling out, brought together those thus deafened, so that they knew that they did not hear his cry, that would still not help him, bracket parentheses, to convince them, and bracket parentheses, and he would acknowledge their excuse. Therefore, if the messenger acted as judge, that was, bracket parentheses, only because, and bracket parentheses, he was made specifically responsible for the judgment that God had specified for him in that case, And this is a sublime knowledge required by everyone on Earth who has authority over bracket parentheses this and bracket parentheses world. So today we started with the beginning of part 5 on the helpers of the Mahdi, and we finished with the end of part 5. This episode was entirely part 5 on about the helpers of the Mahdi. I gotta say, they can't all be winners. And by they, I mean episodes of Chicken Philosophy. And if you are still here, and you're mildly amused, and you're a little disappointed about the fact that this episode is about to end, then I invite you, specifically you, to check out The Multiverse Cartographer Part 18, a special episode of Chicken Philosophy Edward hosted a couple days ago. And aside from that, I hope you have a wonderful week, and go with the blessings of Kyle MacLachlan. And okay.